Okay. Praise God.
Praise God.
All right, come on, let's praise God, huh?
Praise God.
We got people to shoot us, but we can have a hallelujah good time in and out, right? I know I intend to, I don't know about you. I don't know what you came to do, but see, I came to praise the Lord. Amen. Even though I got hooked into singing. I'm still trying to figure out what I was doing up there. And then Thomas said something about, well, do another one of his songs. I'm like, what you mean another one of his songs? I thought Tommy had a song he was going to be doing. Praise God. Will you turn to Philippians 4? Starting with Philippians 4, our scriptural verse for this session will be 4:11. But I'd like to start with reading the first part. The first. I'd like to give honor to God, to my brother, Savior Jesus Christ. And I'd like to thank my pastor, Leslie Thomas, for allowing me to step into this day and to be able to stand this book. I don't take it lightly that he allows us to do this because he's looking to see the love in us and he's also giving us an opportunity to share our views with you. Amen.
Amen.
So we're looking forward to that. My joy and my crown stand firm in the Lord in this day. I plead with Erroneous and I plead with Cynthia to be the to be of the same mind with the Lord. Yes, and I ask you, my true companions, help these women since they have contended at my side in the cause of the gospel, along with Clement and the rest of the co-workers and my co-workers, whom names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. I say again, rejoice. Let your gentleness and be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer, petition, and thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent and praiseworthy, think about such things. Whether you have learned to receive or heard from me, or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. I rejoice greatly in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned but had no opportunity to show it. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content in whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need. I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in every situation, whether with welfare or hunger, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. This part of scripture is talking about how Paul was in prison and that the Philippians sent him a gift. They sent him support. They sent him money to take care of his needs. They knew he was in jail, they knew he couldn't work, he couldn't take care of himself, but they made sure that his needs were being met. It's just like here in the church, when we have needs in the church, we meet the needs in the church. Our giving should be in joy. We should be giving joyfully in our giving. Just like the Philippians did when they gave to Paul. Now we know that even though Paul went through a whole lot of things, but Paul was content for where he was and his situation. We know that faith in God is trust in God. How many here are trusting God for everything? I don't want to tell you or yell it out loud. I want you to tell it, I want you to yell it out loud, but I do want you to take a minute and think about it. In what situation do you find yourself today? Because we all have situations. We all go through things. Just like Paul, no matter what it is that you're going through, you have to learn to be content in that situation. Now, Paul went through a lot. I don't know how many of us think he could take everything to Paul and still come up talking about yes, Lord. Some of us might have been talking about, I don't know, but that second stone was a little much. Why that snake keep biting me, Lord? You know, just a little things, you know. But we know that Paul went through all these things. But no matter what he went through, he never lost his trust in his faith. You know? He knew who it was that he was serving, and he knew why. Paul was a man of focus, of intense focus. He had one thing in mind and he had one thing on me. How do I share the love of Christ? How do I get somebody else to hear about the God I serve? And how do I get them to understand that no matter what they're going through, no matter what's going on in their lives, that the God I serve is able and can help them? We go through a lot of things. We go through sickness, we go through illness. We go through pains, we go through being broke. I don't know about y'all, but that's to me, that's hard. Being broke is hard. When you look at your pocket and you only got about 15 cents, you know it's going to cost a lot of money to get that drink. You know, that broke thing ain't a good thing, you know. But you look in your bank account and you find out, whoops, I'm already $20 over. We need
to realize that God is able to take care of all those things. We don't need to stress about them. We don't need to worry about them. We don't need to be upset about them. We have to learn to be content in our hearts and our giving each and every day. God blesses each and every one of us. Everyone I see sitting here this morning, I don't see nobody in need. I don't see nobody anymore. I see a God that has taken care of each and every one of us because we were doing what He already told us to do. He told us to take care of the widows and the orphans and those who were in need. We give on a regular basis, and we need to be giving that giving joyfully. Joyfully. I know Pastor was talking not long ago about the hardest thing to separate from a rich man is his wife. He ain't gonna give up no money. He'll tell you to be thankful and be happy and be safe, but he ain't gonna give you no money. But we know that there's joy in giving, and it's also worship in giving. Paul also said in Corinthians, to this very hour, we hunger and thirst. We are in rags, we are brutally treated, we are homeless. We work hard with our own hands. When we are cursed, we bless. And when we're persecuted, we endure. And when we're slandered, we answer kindly. We have become the scum of the earth and the garbage of the world right up to this very moment. People look at us because we say we're Christians, and it's not always in a good light. They always say that we're stuck up, that we're not bending, we're not yielding, we're not flexing. We say that there's only one way to Christ, and that's through our love for Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And we're adamant about it, and we don't make no bones about it. And I'm not asking for forgiveness, I'm just telling you the truth. If you want to come to God, you have to come through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. No matter what it is that you're talking about, that's the only way. And we need to be able to stand firm in our beliefs and to tell people what it is exactly that we believe. And why do we believe? Just because Paul went through all these things, he was brutalized, he was cursed, and when he was cursed, he was still blessing people. He was still giving people the gospel. When they persecuted him and they tortured him and they beat him, he still was giving the gospel. He was still sharing the good news of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
No matter what he was going through. Can you say no matter what you're going through that you're doing the same? Are you being that beacon of hope and light for somebody today? Are you telling someone about the Lord that you serve? You don't have to go out and evangelize all the down the street, but are you telling your neighbors? Are you telling your children? Are you telling your brother-in-law, your sister-in-law? Are you telling that one that anybody in the whole family talking to? The one that don't want, you don't even want to come visit it, but you know you need to share the word of gospel. You need to be about the Father's business. Sharing a word that will bring joy to that person. Because even though they may be mean and obstinate and hard-headed and stubborn, when the Lord finishes with them, they'll be full of joy and we'll be able to have a good time.
All
right. We won't have to worry about where they're coming. We'll be happy to see them come through the door.
Yes.
But God can change them, not us. But we have to plant that seed, and somebody has to water it, and somebody has to come along with it. The Holy Spirit comes along with us. When it says, we have been persecuted, we endured, but we are slandered, we answer kindly to it. We know that we've been through a lot, just like Paul, and Paul kept going through everything over and over and over again. No matter where he went, he found trouble. No matter where he went, he shared the good news. There was always somebody receptive enough to hear the word of God. 1 Timothy 6:6-8 says, but godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into this world, and we can take nothing out of it. But if we have food and clothing, will we be content? My question was, will you be? just food and clothing. Because you got, you brought nothing into this world that you can take nothing out of. But you have to learn to be content in whatever situation you find yourself. Because Paul was content. And this, when we talk about the contentment, we're talking about a godly contentment. We're talking about when you have a view of God's view of contentment, not the world's. Because you see, if you're looking at it, if you put things in God's eyes, you get to see an old different view of life. Because he sees the beginning from the end. We can't do that. I'm not trying to say that we can. But what I'm saying is you just put yourself in a position to try to see how God sees us in our situation. And then we can get to the place where we know we can take nothing with us, or we can take, that we didn't bring anything with us, we can take nothing out. We know that whatever we have here, we should be content. Because we believe I'm going to a place that's got gold walls and marble floors and estimates all over the windows. I'm going to a place called heaven. I'm going to a place that's not made by him. I know that what I have here is nothing compared to what he has for me before. The eye has not seen and the ear has not heard. God has you. And we have to be ready to tell somebody about that goodness. Today, Pastor was talking about the Romans Road and all the things he did. I want y'all to know, even though he mentioned my name, I went that bad.
Yeah.
I was worse. I was a lot worse. I'm just glad he didn't cut it off. But we have to continue to look at things through God's eyes. And we have to be content in our situation. No matter what you're going through, because some of us have sicknesses, some of us have illnesses, some of us are just depressed. We need to take on a God's view of life. Because at that view, there's compassion, there's love, there's gentleness, there's understanding, there's wisdom, there's patience, there's joy unspeakable. How many people in here have been moved by the Holy Spirit?
Oh, my God.
That is joy unspeakable.
Yes.
And when you have that kind of joy, and you can operate in that kind of joy, there's nothing. Because there's nothing too hard for God, right? You already know that he's able. TJ was singing it loud and clear. He's able. He's doing pretty good too. I like that. And he brought me presents. Where the rest of my presents? TJ hooked me up and looked for the rest. It says, in the Bible study and the purpose-driven life, the book tells us that God created everything and everything belongs to him. We don't own anything. Everything was created to bring him glory, including us. When we look at things through God's eyes and not from a world's view, what have I here on earth that I am? When you look at your life right now, are you content? What is the one thing that you can say I'm content about? You may not be content about everything, but do you have one thing that you can say I am content about? Just one. Boy, I see everybody thinking, I'm scared. I might even get an answer. Sickness or anything. I'm content because I don't have to worry. I think about my godly family, I put my trust in the Lord. When I put my trust in Him, I put that trust also in you. Because I know that you will reach out to others, that you will touch people's lives. And we touch somebody's life each and every day. Maybe you don't even know. Would you say, God bless you? Would you look somebody in the eye and say, thank you? Would you tell somebody that the God I serve is able? And I'd like to introduce you to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, because that cancer that was just pronounced on you is not truly a blessing. I can introduce you to somebody who can introduce you to eternal life. You can be content to know that this is not my home. That my home is in heaven. I'm content to know that everything that I do is going to bring glory to God. I know that nothing belongs to me, no matter even what I got on, don't belong to me. It belongs to God. And everything I do and everything I say should bring glory to His name. I should be focused on how can I be content and how can I have the joy and my heart to share. I want to be able to share what I have with you. And that's why I'm here. Susie, I still want to thank you. I know that's your giving, but I'm trying to give. Even though my wife looking at me like, you don't need no thing. But we need to be able to share what we have. It's a wonderful thing to see family in Christ. Somebody that you didn't even know a while ago, but today you call them sister. Or you call them brother. And when you talk about our Father, you're talking about the same God. These are the things that we need to practice on a regular basis. Content. I'm content with loving you. I'm content to know that you love me. And I'm content to let you know I got no money. For Felicia Starr. But I need to let you know that even though Paul went through all these little shipwrecks, beatings, stones, he was content because he knew who he was in the Savior. And I'm content because I know who I serve. My question to you is, who are you serving? And are you content in yourself? Do you even think about how wonderful it is to serve a God like this? When you start to look and go through your mindset and you go, I'm struggling. I may not have a whole, I don't know where tomorrow's meal is coming from. But you know what? I'm content because God will make a way out of it.
That's right.
I'm content because I know that no matter what I'm going through, God is able to handle it. When I'm fearing for my children's safety at the school, the people are walking in and just starting shooting and doing all kinds of things for no reason, I'm content because my God is covering my child because He covers me. I'm content in knowing that He's able to take care of everything that I put into His hands to take care of. I don't worry about things because I know He's able. And I trust Him to the fullest. I know that by my faith in Him, that I can do all things with Christ that's strong in me.
Yes.
Okay? I don't have to worry about it. I trust Him. I lean on Him every day. Someone is getting up as hard. I'm truly leaning on God. Just to be able to move around and to get busy. And it says, 2 Corinthians 2:11, 2 Corinthians 11:9 says, and when I was with you and needed something, I was not a burden to you.
For the brothers who came from Macedonia supplied what I needed. I kept myself from being a burden to you in any way and will continue to do so. Paul did not want the Philippians or anyone else to think he was preaching just for the money. Paul knew that when the Philippians gave their gift to him, that they were sending a temple to heaven. Paul knew that the Philippians blessed him, that God would bless him. He already knew it. He would let him know that it's not because I want money, but I want to see you grow. I want to see you become the person and the people that God has called you to be. I need you to continue to move forward, to grow into maturity, and to be able to stand on your own two feet, and to be able to tell somebody about His goodness, His mercy, and His grace.
Yes.
You need to be able to tell somebody that my God can do all things. There's nothing impossible for Him. And when you start to look at it through the light of Him being able to move that mountain that you say move, for Him to be able to tell something to stop, the pain to stop in your arm, in your leg, or your back, because He is able to take away that pain. When you're hurting in the midnight hour and you've got nobody else to turn to, turn to God. Call on the one who can actually help you. Reach out to the God who is able to supply all your
needs. Yes.
And Lord, if you don't take away the pain, I know you got to help. I know that there's a point to you. I know that I'm supposed to learn something from you. And that learning is something that you'll be able to share with someone else down the line. God doesn't waste anything.
Amen.
Nothing. And when we think that He's not listening, He's listening. Just because He don't answer doesn't mean to deny it. It just may not be your time.
Amen.
But He will answer in His own time. And when He does answer, you will know that it's Him that's answering. There'll be no mistake. Because only He can move in that way. And you know that it's Him who makes the difference. So I just want to thank you all. I don't want to be too long here today. I just wanted you to be learned to be content in whatever situation you find yourself. To be able to stand on your own two feet and tell somebody about you. And to be able to definitely quote a scripture, tell somebody, be able to reach out. And for anyone that you know that is in need, who's hurting, who doesn't have the ability to take care of themselves, and you have an extra cook, please share your cook. Please give it to them. It says, are you concerned? Are you content with your Lord and Savior? Is your giving there the joy? When you're giving, is there joy in your giving? There is a line in the song that says, when I look around and I look things over, I won't complain. We don't need to be complaining. We need to be content in our situation. The only way to be truly content is to trust God for everything. In everything that Paul went through, he never lost his faith in God. And I'm going to put this plea out here just for ministry. Please support your men and women in ministry. They go out of their way to read, to learn, to teach. Pastor Thomas spends many hours counseling, spending time talking to you, spending time going through whatever it is that you're going through. He's not going to turn anybody away. We need the support of you all to continue that work. Amen?
Amen.
So we need you just as much as you need us. Amen? So we want you to be content in your giving. We want you to be content.
to be content in everything that you do for God, because we know that He's a God who is able to do abundantly above and beyond all that we can imagine and ask. Amen?
Amen.
At this time, the doors of the church are open. Well, you can't give a preaching a mic, can you? Okay. We got the doors of the church open. If there's anybody who would like a special prayer, please come. We still have deacons here, we have ministers here, and we're able to take the time to pray for you. Don't leave here the way that you can be. If you don't know our Lord and Savior for yourself, please come. Give your life to Christ. Just because I believe everyone is here is saved, I have to put the plea out because you never know what you're going to be saying. Amen?
Amen.
So please. I see my esteemed colleague, Reverend Brown, is in the house.
Amen.
He's sneaking in. God need to get on, he need to be here today. Ow, that hurt. I think I got in trouble for saying that. Father, I want to give this afternoon to thank you for the many blessings. Lord, we thank you for your word and the forth today. And this. May it multiply, Lord, may it go out into the world and come back a thousandfold, a millionfold, a zillionfold, Lord. We want it to be just like the sands on the seashore, Lord. We want to fill this place up with your word and with your people, with your praise, Lord. We're asking that everything that is said and done for the rest of the day brings glory to your name. Put somebody in our path today, Lord, that we can tell about your goodness and your grace. Let somebody know who it is. Let us let someone know who it is that we serve. Give us a word to speak to somebody, Lord. Somebody is seeking you right now. Put them in our path, Lord, so that they can hear from you through us. Put a word in our hearts and our minds, Lord. Renew our minds every day so that we'll be able to keep our minds focused, steadfast. These things we ask in the sweet and powerful name of Jesus. And that all God's children say.
Amen. Amen.